Welcome to Java Forum. Today we are going to see how to install and configure Apache Netbeans 10.0 on CentOS 7 operating system using Oracle JDK 11. So before I proceed to install, I have already installed the Oracle JDK 11. So here I have installed JDK 11 using RPM. So JDK 11 was installed in the path /usr/java/JDK11. So no need to set class path. So automatically Java will be available in the terminal. So here you can see that Java is already available in the path, so that Apache Netbeans 10 can be run. So instead of setting Java underscore home, this is the one of the best solution. So you can install Oracle JDK 11 as RPM. So now I'm going to extract Apache Netbeans 10.0, which is already downloaded from the Netbeans website. So I'm going to extract this tar.gz file. So I am extracting the netbeans to /opt directory. So extraction was successful. So let us navigate the Apache Netbeans 10.0 directory. So this is the directory structure of Netbeans 10.0, so which contains a lot of free tools. So now I'm going to execute the Netbeans. So I'm going to the bin folder now. So here you can see the executable files are there. So I'm executing /netbeans. So here you can see Apache Netbeans 10.0 is starting now. So because Java is already available in the path. So Netbeans 10.0 is started. So now first step is we have to install the plugins. So here you can see that available plugins nb-javac library. So this nb-javac library should be installed. So this, for this you need an internet connection to get download the nb-javac library. So it will be downloaded and installed, then only we can able to compile and run the Java 11 programs. So nb-javac plugin is installed successfully. So now we are going to proceed with the creating a new project. So first I am going to create a Java modular project. So when I am creating a first project, you can see that Java will be getting activated since this is the first program. So you should wait for some time. So Java SC will be getting activated. Yes, Java is getting activated. So here I'm going to give some name. So I am giving the name modular programming. So JDK 11 will be the default Java for this project. So here you can see that modular programming is getting created now. So my next step is I am going to create one module. So right click the project, new module. So here I am giving some name as com.javaforum. So module name is com.javaforum. So automatically module-info.java is getting created. So you can see the left pane. So make sure that you have same directory structure. So this module-info.java will be in the default package. So now I'm going to create a new package name. I'm creating a package name as com.javaforum, which means module name and package name should be same. So now I'm going to create one class called HelloPrint. So this HelloPrint class will print one welcome message. So this will be in com.javaforum module. So I am typing that welcome message. This welcome message will is a return type is string. So public string print hello method. I am typing that welcome message, the return keyword. So save the file. So now go to module-info.java and I am typing exports com.javaforum. So that these modules will be accessed by other modules. So I am saving all the files. So now I am going to create another module. So I am giving the name as org.javaforum. So same module-info.java will be created. So module-info.java will be available in the default package. So now I am going to create one package in org.javaforum. So that package name will be same as module name. So org.javaforum is the package name and module name also org.javaforum. So inside that org.javaforum package, I am going to create one class called Hello World. So this Hello World class is going to invoke the HelloPrint class from com.javaforum. So here you can see that in Apache Netbeans 10, I have created a multiple modules in the same project. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to import that com.javafrm dot hello print class. So in the modinfo.java.org.javafrm, I am typing requires com.javafrm so that com.javafrm will be available in org.javafrm for import. So now I am going to print that welcome message by invoking that hello print class and creating an object for hello print class and invoke that print hello method, which will return the welcome message as a string. So I save all the file. So I'm going to run this program. Yes, successful. So Apache NetBeans 10.0 installation on CentOS 7 Linux operating system is successful. So we have seen the simple Java 11 modular programming example. So make sure that your Linux operating systems support that graphics. And this NetBeans IDE performance purely depends upon your desktop manager of Linux operating system and graphics card which you installed. So NetBeans 10.0 successfully runs in CentOS 7. So subscribe our YouTube channel JavaFRM for more videos. Stay tuned.